I think photography for me is something that happened by chance. It wasn't a childhood hobby. I think I only picked up a camera like say 4 years ago. Now what happened is that I can't remember where I chanced upon the works of this French photographer, Henri Cartier-Bresson. I think he was the one who co-founded Magnum. So he had this series of black and white street photography. That was just amazing. So I think that's how I actually really got into photography. Yeah. So I more specifically film photography. Because I think for Cartier-Bresson, he was shooting on the old Tri-X. Of course, the current Tri-X is a bit different from what we have now, but yeah. So that's how it started. Very large part is something by choice. Okay, but the one thing I like about film is that the texture is just very nice. It has this very organic feel. Whereas digital is a bit different in that sense. So, and the other thing that people don't realize about film photography is well, with digital, you can, you know, the preview screen, you take a few shots, and you get to see which is good. While some people think it's great, I will never miss a shot, but my personal opinion is that you're losing the experience. The fun about photography is not being able to see what you get immediately. And like how Cartier-Bresson said it, the moment the photographer presses the shutter, that's the moment he's the most creative. So I think with digital photography, that element is missing. Because he's just too comfortable with the preview screen. So even like when I train photographers, even if they're using digital cameras, I always make a point that please don't use the preview screen. Just frame with your eyes on the viewfinder. If you get it right, you get it right. There's a lot of satisfaction to it. So that's my take. A lot of patience. For the kind of work I do is I'm a wedding photographer. More precisely, a wedding day photographer. So in many ways, you are like a photojournalist. You wait for moments to happen. You sit around. You learn to anticipate. So it builds up a lot of character in the sense that you become more patient. So some things don't just happen on the spot. So a lot of times you have to actually wait for it to happen. So I guess patience. Yeah. And that satisfaction when you get a shot. It's just marvelous. Actually, every wedding is interesting for me. Okay, the one thing I like about film photography is how you don't get to see it immediately. So you take a shot hoping that you turn out alright. So the moment you go to the dark room, you have the films developed. That is the most satisfying. You can see the picture that you take appearing on a negative and things like that. So to me, that experience, that feeling that you have to wait for like a couple of days to see the shots. Well, the stressful part may be initially when I first started photography. But I guess there's no difference if you take with a digital camera. But right now, not so much. Because I think with film photography, you sort of train yourself. Because you have to compose everything on the viewfinder. And you have to know the exposure and things like that. So that comes with experience. Which for me, no, it's not stressful now. In fact, for me, it's actually quite fun. So I still like the thrill of you see the shot, you capture it, but you're not sure whether you got it. So when you go back, you develop your films, it's there. So I think that part is the fun part. So I don't think there's much stress, at least not now. If I have a choice, I will always shoot film. But I see the benefits of digital. For instance, under very low light condition, well, my personal opinion, although I'm a fan of film, I think the film is no match for the digital. So but other than that, like I was telling you, I just love the film. Because a lot of my works are actually influenced by cinema. Cinema today is still shot on film. So I have a choice, always on film. But with digital, this in certain cases is actually more useful to shot on digital, like low light and things like that. Oh yes, for my personal works, of course I'm a fan of black and white, everybody knows that. So always in black and white. But the other thing is that I only shoot for my personal work in nomography cameras. So I think I started with the Holga. Okay, this nomography thing happened much later. It wasn't popular then. I think at that point you only had the Holga and things like that. But for my personal work, only on nomography. So it's nice because for nomography it's a very simple camera. It's how camera were first made. Single aperture, single shutter speed, single ISO. So you just everything is by touch and feel. Okay, for my kind of work, wedding photography, for me the moment matters. then maybe exposure and things like that, and maybe composition. So that, ideally we want everything, but if you're talking a priority, then I'd rather have the moment. Because once you miss the moment, you miss it. As a matter of fact, it's very applicable. I see metamorphosis, transformation as, because as photographers, we always have ideas, a blueprint in our head. But that doesn't mean you can sort of transform the blueprint that is in your head into real imagery. So I see metamorphosis or transformation as that process of transferring mental imagery into a real picture. So that's how I see it. Which I think is an important aspect for every photographer. I think every photographer will have a mental image of what they want. But sometimes the real thing might be quite different. Y'all keep experimenting. The thing is that no one thing is for everyone. For instance, wedding is for me, but it may not be for you. So I think for a lot of young photographers, it doesn't matter whether you're shooting on film or digital. You have to keep experimenting. Keep looking for things that really inspires you. I think it's not only for photography, anything in life for that matter. Not so much on technical skills. Things like that you can pick up. You know, things like how to transform mental imagery into a real image. That is something that cannot be taught. Yeah.